Hello and welcome to the third part of our tutorial series about the creation of the promo video for the Squash & Stretch Pro Cartoon Bundle. In the previous part, we created drafts of the individual scenes of the video. Today, we want to combine all scenes into one fluid animation. Today, we first start in Premiere Pro to take care of the general timing, in particular to make sure that everything fits well to the background music and that the pacing feels well. We'll do this in Premiere Pro since compared to After Effects, everything is a bit more interactive and optimized for real-time playback in Premiere Pro. So here I have an empty Premiere Pro project where I only imported my background music so far, which has been kindly provided by premiumbeat.com. Now I open After Effects, select all the scenes we created in the previous part, and drag them into the project panel of Premiere Pro. Now we select them in the order in which they should appear and drag them onto this icon to create a new sequence. Now we also drag the music into the sequence. As you can see, the clips are currently way longer than our music. So let's play them back and see where we can trim them. Here I feel is a good point to transition to the second scene. Here we can transition to the third scene. In general, I try to set the transitions at points where a musical phrase ends, and this is typically also at a beat. If you do this kind of work a lot, you might also want to look into our extension Beat Edit, which can add beat markers to your audio clips to guide you finding good points that fit to the music. Here I want the fourth scene to start. And here, finally, the last scene should start. I recommend to spend some time experimenting with the timing until you get something that feels right. Before you continue, it is also a good idea to render this rough cut and show it to your client so that they can approve before you continue with the next step. Now we select the audio clip, and by pressing the M key, we set a marker at each point where a new scene starts. Then we go back to After Effects and import the same audio clip. We drag it onto this icon to create a new composition, and now we have the same markers we created in Premiere Pro, also in our After Effects composition. Let's rename the composition to Main, and then go to the Composition Settings and make it very big. Our normal project size is 1920 by 1080, but now let's add ×3 behind the number to make it 3 times as large. Now we open the comp of the first scene, select all layers, and copy them into our main comp. Then we open the second scene, copy all layers, and paste them in the main composition too. We move them so that they start at the first marker because this is where the second scene should start. Then we create a parent null with Squash and Stretch so that we can move all layers of the second scene so that they line up nicely with the first scene. Then we proceed in the same way with the remaining scenes. Once all of the scenes are inserted, we delete all background layers except for one of them, since we want a single background for the entire composition. We move the one remaining background layer to the bottom of the layer stack, make its duration the same as the duration of the comp, reset its position to center it in the comp, and then make it bigger so that it covers the entire composition. Then we lock the background layer so that we don't accidentally move it anymore. Currently, we have one line layer per scene, but since we want to have one continuous animation of the line, we need to join all of them into a single path. The easiest way to do this is to take the shape layer of the very first part and to extend it step by step using the existing paths as a guide. Once the path is done, we can delete the other line layers and move our resulting line to the very bottom, right above the background layer. Now we set the composition size back to 1920 by 1080 and need to animate a camera move over our scene. Instead of using an After Effects camera, which only works in 3D space, we simply create a null object that we can use to move the entire scene around. We name it Camera, and then we select all layers that have no parent layer yet, and parent them to the new camera null. Now we can move the camera around by changing its position. We keyframe the camera position as needed to get the desired camera move. I'll fast forward here since this manual keyframing of the position is rather boring work. Next, we want to animate the line, so in the contents of the line layer, we reveal the shape properties and add a trim path. If we keyframe the end of the line to 0%, the line disappears completely. By increasing the end over time, the line appears step by step. So similar to the camera move, we now keyframe the trim path as needed. Again, I fast forward here until I am done with the keyframing. Once we are done keyframing the end of the line, we can also keyframe the start of it so that at the very end of the animation, the line forms the final rectangle. Now our project looks like this. If you compare this to the final video closely, you will notice that in the final video, the line always changes the direction exactly at beats or at other key points in the background music. By connecting events in the animation with sets in the music like this, everything feels more natural and seamless. So I really recommend to fine-tune the keyframes until they fit to the music. And as mentioned before, our extension Beat Edit can generate the beat markers on the audio layer, which simplifies the process a lot. To summarize, today we have combined all scenes of the video into one fluid animation, and the key elements are already animated. At the moment, everything feels still very static since most texts are not animated yet. But we will change this in the next and final part where we will animate all of those remaining texts. Again, this is Eric D. Kirk from AmaWorld.com, and we'll see you next time.